I love you, Allah.
Assalamu alaikum. This is your brother Rayan Arab recording for I Love You Allah Productions. Many people want to enter paradise, but are unwilling to take these sacrifices of enter paradise. Many people want to be safe on the day of judgment, but do not know what's going to happen on the day of judgment in order for them to be safe. They don't know the details. In order for you to be safe on the day of judgment, then you have to work really hard for the sake of Allah, and you have to know what is going to happen on the day of judgment. If we are going to speak about resurrection and the afterlife, this could take like a few days. In fact, it could take up to a year or two. So I decided to talk to you about something very, very important, and that is As-Sirat, the bridge that we are all going to cross on. This bridge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا, and every single one of you will cross this. Nobody will be safe from crossing this bridge. This bridge will be so thin, even thinner than your hair, and sharp, so sharp, sharper than a sword or a knife, or sharper than the sharpest sword or knife. Every single person is going to have to cross this bridge, whether he is a good person or an evil person. But for the evil people, when they cross the bridge, it will not be like those who cross the bridge of those good people. The good people will be able to cross it very quickly, and they will not have to suffer. As for the evil people are those who did bad actions, and yet they had some good actions as well, but they did many bad actions. For those people, they will have to suffer. Each person dependent on his good actions and his bad actions. If you are very straight with Allah, then you will fly on this sirat, on this bridge, as if you are a hurricane, very quick. And if you are even more straight with Allah, then you will cross this bridge as in a blink of an eye, even quicker. But if you aren't straight with Allah, then you will have to walk on this bridge. And if you are like really bad with Allah, then you will have to crawl on this bridge. And if you were just like an evil person who did no good deeds at all, or did a few here and there, but most of your deeds are bad, then you will fall off of the bridge. Every time you try to walk, you will start shaking, and then you will fall off, and you will fall into the hellfire. Now, under this bridge, this thin line will be fire, blazing fire, waiting for somebody to fall into it. And only those bad people who did really bad with Allah will fall into it. And those people who were insincere, those munafiqun, the hypocrites, they are going to fall into it. But the believer, he is going to have light. His light is going to shine, and it's going to allow him to walk on that day over the sirat very fast. Or he may even, as I said earlier, he may even fly on it, you know, like really quick, like a hurricane or a tornado. So his light is going to save him. What kind of light does he have? He has the light of faith. He believed in Allah. He was straight with Allah. He used to walk to the masjid at night or in Fajr. During Fajr time, he used to walk to the masjid. He had good character. He didn't cheat. He didn't lie. He didn't steal. So then Allah gives him this light that he doesn't give to anybody on that day. Even the hypocrites, they see the light of the believers and they say, come stand next to us. Give us some of your light. But the believers say, get out of here. Go back to the world and get your own light. It's too late for you, right? So we want to make sure that we have that correct intention, that we are straight with Allah, so Allah could save us on that day and allow us to flee into paradise over the sirat. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to allow us to be of those who follow the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, because if we follow him externally and internally, then Allah will have no reason to throw us in the hellfire. He will allow us to follow this sirat very quick and walk over it or run over it as quick as possible. Why? Because we were straight. Imagine if you work in a company and you have a group of staff who are doing a really good job. Would you think about delaying their salary or kicking them out of the company? No way, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is even wiser than you, because He is your creator. So if He sees you doing good, then there is no reason for Him to throw you in the hellfire or to allow you to suffer on that day. The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said, وَتَمَسَّكُ بِهَا وَعُضُّ عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِثِ. He said about his sunnah, hold on to it tightly and bite it with your molar teeth. If you hold on to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, then you will be safe on that day. Jazakumullahu khairan wa barakallahu fikum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.